MPC machine allows you to edit notes that have already been recorded on the pad. This is great for when you've recorded a drum sequence or a melody and one or two of the notes in the wrong timing. So let's test how this works. So for this example, I'm going to use the string sounds that come as part of MPC machine version 1.07 in the project MM Trap sequence. So, as you can hear, every pad is supposed to be in every quarter note of the bar, but one of the pads is wrong. So, to edit that pad, which is this pad here, hold down the pad and press the record button. If you look carefully on the pop-up window that appears, you will see it says 1 of 4 for note number. That means there are 4 notes for this pad recording, and we are currently looking at number 1. There's a green horizontal marker which indicates whereabouts within that sequence that note is going to be played. I'm going to count every time this pad plays and see if I can spot the mistake.
1, 2, 3, 4.
So the third one is the one with the mistake. Start again.
1, 2, 3, 4.
So the third one. So where it's got note number, we press the plus to note number 3. And we can see that it's slightly early. So what we can do, we can shift the position at the bottom to move, nudge it forward a 16th. See that? I'll do that again, just so you know. We can make it go earlier if we want. Obviously wrong. How much we shift it is based on what the quantize value says. So if we change the quantize value to be an 8, for example, and then we change the position minus, it jumps in bigger stages or quarters, much bigger jumps. So it was in 16ths. Keep pushing the plus. That's really all there is to it. That's how you can edit your sounds to get in timing without having to record the whole sequence again. So I hope that clears a few things up. Exactly the same for drums as well. I'm going to make a quick drum pattern and edit the positions of one of the sounds of the recording after I've stopped.
So if we want that other dance chant to be on one of those snares . Get your finger on it, press the record button. There's only 2 on this sequence, so we select the second one. And then we can move the position. That's really all there is to it.
When you're looping a number of bars in MPC machine, the note editor acts a little bit different. Let me show you what I mean. So I'm going to record an extra snare hit, then I'm going to loop the end of the bar. As you can hear, there are now 4 pad recordings for this pad within this loop. Remember, to edit a pad recording, hold down the pad, in this case it's pad number 2, then press the record button to open the note edit dialog.
This time, it will come up with a red line indicating our loop portion. If it says one of four, that means there are four snare recordings within this loop for the currently selected pad. Always remember when looping that it counts the number of recordings within the loop, not on the whole track. So for example, this snare recording may have 8 hits within the whole track, but within this loop portion, there are only 4, and that's what we're concerned about. Okay, I've highlighted the second note because I'm going to delete it. So I'm on note number 2, and now I'm going to press the delete note button, and there it's gone. So that's just deleted the second note within that loop, and now I'm going to turn off the loop to hear the full sequence. And there you have it. That is no editing, both unlooped and looped in MPC Machine. Any questions, email us. Okay, thank you for watching.